Truck in, Rip City next station, star. You're crazy with the heat.
Credit's no good for a notion salesman.
Good! Good!
Why not? What's the matter with credit?
It's old fashioned. Charlie, you're an Anvil salesman. Your firm gives credit?
No, sir.
Nor anybody else.
Cash for the merchandise.
Cash for the button hooks.
Cash for the cotton goods.
Cash for the hard goods.
Cash for the soft goods.
Cash for the fancy goods.
Cash for the nubbins.
And the biggins and the burgers.
Cash for the hog tip.
Cash game name it up.
Cash for the crackers.
And the pickles and the pie paper.
Look, what do you talk? What do you talk? What do you talk? What do you talk? What do you talk?
What do you get?
What do you talk?
You can talk, you can talk. You can bicker, you can talk. You can bicker, bicker, bicker. You can talk, you can talk. You can talk, 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 talk. Bicker, bicker, bicker. You can talk all you want, but it's different than it was.
No, it ain't. No, it ain't. But you got it. Open territory.
Shh, 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 shh.
Well, it's policy for men and trouble. People want to go, want to get, want to get, want to get up and go. 7, 8, 9, 10, 12, 14, 20, 23 miles in the county seat.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Who's going to bet you're not a little bit of 2x4 at the store anymore?
What do you talk? What do you talk?
Where do you get it? Not the Model T at all. Take a gander at the store, at the modern store, at the present day store, at the present day modern departmentalized grocery store.
What do you talk? What do you talk? What do you talk? What do you talk? What do you talk?
Where do you get it?
What do you talk? What do you talk? What do you talk?
Where do you get it?
Talk, you can pick it. You talk, you can pick it. Talk, 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 bicker, bicker, bicker. You can talk all you want, but it's different than it was.
No, it ain't, but you got it on the territory.
Why? You need a investigator trouble. You need to put the cracker in the bag, do the bag. You need a investigator, an airtight sanitary bag. From the cracker barrel, obsolete.
Cracker barrel, wait, out the window with the mail pouch. Cut club, charm by the stove. Change the approach to the traveling salesman. Made it pretty hard.
No, it didn't, but you got it on the territory.
Gone. Gone with the whole head. Scared Demi John, gone with the sugar barrel, put the barrel milk pan, gone with the tub and the pail and the deer. Ever meet a fella by the name of Hill?
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 No!
Just a minute!
Now he doesn't know the territory. Never worries about his line. Or the cracker barrel being obsolete, or the you need a biscuit in an airtight sanitary package with a Model 3 Ford.
Just a minute.
Never worries about his line. Or a doggone thing. He's just stop bang, big bell ringing, big hog, red dog.
What's his line? He's a fake, and he doesn't know the territory.
Look, what are you talking? What are you talking?
He's a what? He's a music man. Those clarinets, the gifts and the dimes, the big trombones, the rat-a-tat drums, the big breast piece, and the piccolo, the uniform too, with the shiny gold braid on the coat and a big red stripe front.
Well, I don't know much about bands, but I do know you can't make a living telling big trombones. No, sir. Mandolin picks, perhaps, and here and there a Jew's harp.
No, the fellow sells bands, boys bands. I don't know how he does it. Well, he lives like a king. He dies and he gathers and he plucks and he shines. And when the man dances, certainly the boys, what else? The piper pays him. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
When the man dances, certainly boys, what else? The piper pays him. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
But he doesn't know the territory.
Professor Harold Hill would try to sell them neck-bone Hawkeyes out here.
Gentlemen, you went to the street.
I think I'll have to give Iowa a try.
Don't believe I caught your name.
That's just what I wanted to hear. She passes by. Run her up to me.
I will.
So how are you gonna start the pitch?
Same old way. Keep that music to drop pots. And my next step will be to get your town out of serious trouble, is it?
River City ain't in any trouble.
Well, then I'll have to create something. I'll have to create a desperate need for a boys' band. You remember. Now, what's new around here? What can I use?
Nothing. Set the billiard parlor. Just get a new pool table.
They never had a pool table here before?
No, just billiards.
That'll do. See you later, Mars. Oh, and don't forget. Music teacher.
Music teacher.
Ah, door, Mr. Dunlop.
Yep.
Well, either you're closing your eyes to a situation you don't wish to acknowledge, or you aren't aware of the caliber of disaster indicated by the presence of a pool table in your community. Well, you got trouble, my friend. Right here, I see trouble right here in River City. Quite sure I'm a billion player. Certainly mine, part of the same, I'm always mighty part of the same. I consider that the hours I spend with the cue in my hand are golden. I'm called to play four sets. Cool head, keen eye. Don't ever take a try and get an iron, let it be to yourself with three rail billion shot. Just as I say, take a judgment, brains, and mature, and score the ball, kind game, and I say the nitty boo. Take a shot, a ball, and a lock. I call that small. First we step on the road to the depths of the day. See first, finish snow white with a teaspoon, then beer from a bottle. And soon over the sun is playing for a bunny and a big soup. And listen to some big out of town jazz. Of course we're scared. Not a wholesome turn, we stole, but at least they sit down right on the horse. And I see some stuff of jockey boys sitting on Dan Pat. Big blood boil, I should say. Now we're ready to take one here. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Perfectly frank. Would you like to know what kind of conversation goes on when the local around that ball? Trying out Cubans, trying out Taylor Mays, trying to see bread and beans, and bragging all about how they're going to tell you breathless sense. One by night, they leave the pool and you win the dance.
Trouble. Oh yes, we got trouble. We have got big trouble. We got a team. We got a team. We got a team.
don't throw a line on this.
Thank you.
choir for his fine stereotyping slides. And Will Doppelmeyer, our fine player piano. Player. Yeah. As mayor of River City, I would like to welcome you, River City, the youth, to the 4th of July exercises. Four score. Four score. The members of the school board will now present the patriotic. Nope. The members of the school board will not present the patriotic tableau. Some disagreement about costumes, I suppose. Instead, the Wahtan Yee girl from the local wigwam of Iowatlin will present the spectacle of my wife. In which my wife, Eulalie McKechnie Shin, will take the leading part.
She's right on.
Will you?
so excited since that Frank got and strangling Lewis lay on the mat for 3.5 hours, not moving a muscle. Never mind. I want his credentials.
You hoodlum! You almost blew up his shit!
Thank you, Professor. I have to make an example of this one. Great leader, you know. When he does that game, he just does.
Chili Pie, let me go!
You wild kid, you pay my allowance, girl! His father's one of them day laborers south of town. You wild kid, you tag that brother's girl last Sunday?
I wasn't either tagging.
Whoa! Don't you come to me!
Please just pardon me. Chili Pie!
You want your face off! I know what you was doing. Father Grace is eating. Now you stay away from Alan Sherlock. You'll hear from me too late to rest. Yep. I'll talk to you Monday morning like the band to go to City Hall. 10 o'clock sharp.
Man, I want that spellbinder's credentials.
How's the law be responsible for the boy?
Professor, you don't know this kid. He's tough and he's got his game waiting outside for him.
Well, I'll be careful. Tommy, like to talk to you about the band.
See, Professor, but that's for little kids.
Well, I'm not talking about you playing in the band. You're mechanically minded, aren't you? Did you ever do anything with perpetual motion?
I nearly had it a couple times.
You're my man. Do you realize that nobody's ever invented a music holder for a marching piccolo player? Nobody sang the music.
Geely Clyde, wonder where I could get some wire from.
Look in your cellar. That's where most people keep their wire.
Oh, Tommy. Yes, sir?
Now, Constable, I'll show you how to break up a game.
Young lady, miss, what's your name?
Zanita, I didn't have any idea you was beckoning to me. Gosh.
You know Tommy, she is?
Well, I...
Tommy, this is Zanita. Escort the young lady home.
Oh, except that I'm not going home. I have to go to the library.
Gosh. Yes, sir. Do I have them?
You have them.
See you, fly.
He got
you may have to say so.
Oh?
The mayor happens to own that billiard parlor and that new pool table.
What was my other mistake?
That's Anita. She's the mayor's oldest girl.
Inspector Hill, we need your credentials. We're the school board. Academic certificate.
Nothing of the kind.
We need letters and paper.
Make him put up a bond.
What am I hearing? Say. Ice cream.
Ice cream? But I don't sing, young man, if that's what you're...
All right, talk to me. Down here.
Ice cream.
Up slow.
Ice cream.
See? Singing is always the same song. Now.
Ice cream.
Now you. Ice cream.
Now you, sir.
Ice cream, ice cream, ice cream.
some wonderful panels over at the hotel with you.
Mr. Hill!
Professor
Watson. Professor Watson, what college did they give a degree for? No one living on the street like a Saturday night crowd in a public dance hall.
Well, I don't know about that, Sarah. I'm a conservatory man myself, gold, metal class, a lot of fun.
Even so, that happened to be true. Does that give you the right to follow me around before I go? And another thing, Mr. Hill. I don't easily mesmerize a good deal of some people in this town. Now, they can only bear warning that I have a shelf of reference books in there, which may very well give me some interesting information about you.
How'd you make out with the music teacher?
Scrumptious. Ate out of my hand, and then I tipped my hand.
You did? Boy, did you cut a swat tonight. For a minute, even I thought you knew something about leading the band. Like when you used to imitate that band concert fellow, Beck and Jackwood.
Just you keep your eyes on me for the next 4 weeks.
4 weeks? It only used to take 10 days to finish the store.
Well, it still does, but it takes 4 weeks to the uniform.
No, Greg, you haven't added uniforms.
Uniforms and instruction books.
Instruction books? But you can't pass yourself off as a music professor. Maybe not for 4 weeks.
Mars.
You don't know what the problem is.
I've got a revolutionary new method called the system, where you don't bother with notes.
In 4 weeks, those people are going to want to hear some music. You'll have to lead a band.
When the uniforms arrive, they forget everything else. At least long enough for me to collect and leave. Well, this is a refined operation, son, and I've got it timed right down to the last wave on the great man's hand of the last train on time. Now, Mr. Washburn, if you'll excuse me.
You're going to want yourself a little new, right?
Well,
I can introduce you to Ethel's certifying girl, teach you Sunday school.
No, wide-eyed, eager, wholesome, innocent Sunday school teacher for me. That kind of gal spins webs no spider. Now, listen, boy. A girl with trades and all that purity merely wants to trade my independence for her security. First to march in County Isle, oh, bold and glorious, we know Christine does. No, sir, for no Diana do I put upon. I can tell you that right now. I starve and I hiss, out of ignorance become paperless. I spark and I fizz, for the lady who knows what time it is. I chill and I quiz, and I'm on the stage. She'd like to let us say, you must accept the chairmanship of the ladies' auxiliary class advance.
aren't you, ladies?
Oh, yes, you really must!
Every move you make, Mrs. Shin, he speaks to us sarcastic. Will you say yes, Mrs. Shin?
You Lady McKechnie Shin? Well, dancing with...
Then you accept.
Yes, indeed. I would like to say...
No, thank you. No. Not the lady who plays the piano. Mary Crew, I believe. Well, after all, she is the librarian.
Six series. wrong.
No!
I knew she ran. Thanks, Sara.
Hey, just a minute. Are you soliciting? You haven't got a license.
What? No, man.
Soliciting is statutory in this county. Bad business without a permit. Why haven't you been down to City Hall with your records?
Just this record.
What? What?
That's right, little finger. It's right there.
It is? What's that mean?
Well, it means that your son's little finger is perfectly situated to operate the spit valve from B-flat to the horn.
That good?
Good. Ladies, that America has a blast of your son's finger that costs 50 cents.
Where can I get one of those horns?
Sign here, Mr. Mayor. For $17.
Just think, I could have missed this whole thing if I haven't got any sons!
Self-centered woman chasing traffic man comes to town. See, the fact that he plans his commodity and music does not
See, when you keep it tight enough to hold the music steady, you cut off the circulation and you can't wiggle your fingers. Meanwhile, you could go blind.
Tommy! It's Papa!
That's the first thing I said all night!
Yes, George!
That's the very first thing I said, Riley! Hey, with the horse! Getting that man's credentials I said morning of July 4th, 1912. And now look! My wife's off dancing, spending all hours sitting in the hole.
What,
the school board is singing up street and down alleys. My wife's girl's fooling around with some wild kid. And my business falling off so far, I can't find the balance sheet.
Mention, I found some interesting information in this book about Professor Hill's alma mater.
Zoo?
University.
Oh, I know all about that. That gets all the thing I can get out of here. Gary, conservatory, class of all five.
If you could take some time to read a little bit about conservatory, I know you have to listen to my program.
I like this one. At this hour of the day, nonsense. The Wells Fargo wagon.
It could be the band instrument.
The band instrument?
Now, Miss Mary, about that book?
Come, George, to the
execution.
Your daughter and I are going to study behind your back.
Why, you?
We'd rather do it in front of your back, but...
You what? Never mind!
Zanita scared you, but I'm not. I should think you'd hate to have your own daughter scared you. Geely fly.
I'm the one you want for. Take your hands off my daughter, or I'll fly that horse with you till hell won't ever stand.
Now, George!
That one good by you, madam. Yes! And now, get out of this public square!
I got as much right in a public square as anybody.
Right! How do you think you ride around here? Ain't any offended to swing the activities of that spellbinding single salesman? You know what I see with all of you? Reform school! Now get out! Get out, you wild kid! You watch your phraseology, young woman. Go home. You let me?
Yes, George.
You tend to your dance.
My dance.
I'll have it here.
Mr. West, if I could just make you understand.
No, you can't. And by the way, thanks for nothing. I read that book you gave me from cover to cover for a week now and didn't find a thing.
Mr. Mayor,
I'll settle your ass as soon as I get these premises off my own skirt.
All right, but in the meantime, I want you to know I'm vouching for Tommy G. Well, that boy's got the confidence of every kid in town. And you'll be waiting in line to shake his hand by the time our band plays its first concert.
By the time your band plays its first concert, you'll have to foregather the wheelchairs on account of the broken legs they'll be getting by tripping over their beards. I'll tell you something, my fine young feather, my feather gum. Never mind! Albert, Casey, Hubert, Olin! I want this man's references, and I want them tonight! Don't let him out of your sight, he's slippier than a Mississippi sturgeon!
You mean you want us to get his credentials?
Get his papers or get him in jail! Couldn't make myself any clearer if I was a butt hook in the well water.
Professor Hill, I think Bear should just behave bothersomely, and I think it was wonderful of you coming to Thomas' defense.
That was not.
Yes, it was.
Oh no, a man can't dodge the issue every time a little personal risk is involved. What is it the poet says? Coward dies a thousand deaths, the brave man will survive. Well, unfortunately, of course, the mayor was pretty upset at my disability, however. Now he said to me, oh, I suppose a recommendation from a musical authority like yourself would help. Oh, think of asking to do a thing like that.
Why, Professor Hill?
You would?
I'd be glad to. I only wish I was more informed. I
need
to talk to you about Winter's cornet.
His cornet? Mother of her own key?
Yes, I'm sure it's fine. You see, he never touches it. The first week or so, we made a few experimental flats, I guess you'd say.
Yes, yes, flats.
And he sings the minuet from G.D. Almost constantly. And he never touches the cornet.
Well, you see,
he says you told him it wasn't necessary. And if he thought about the minuet from G, he wouldn't have to bother with the notes. That Professor
Miss Marion, the think system is a revolutionary method, I'll admit. So is Galileo's conception of the heavens. Columbus' conception of the egg. Look. Bach's conception of the well-tempered clavichord. Now, I cannot discuss these things here in public, but if you allow me to call, when may I call?
Or any night this week.
Yes, congratulations. Let's see now. You know all week I've tried to give you fellows my representative credentials, but you always seem to get off the subject somehow. Now, I've just what you want over at my hotel. Take me a second.
Hold on there. Afraid we'll have to go with you.
Yes, well, let's see if I have my key. What's this? Oh, a testimonial from Madame Reaney. First female bassoon player ever to appear on the Red Pass Circuit. Her stage name, of course. Actually, she was from Moline. Lida Rose Quackenbush.
Could I see that for a minute?
Oh, you'll never forget the name. Lida Rose. Same as the old song. Lida Rose, I'm home again, Rose.
To get the sun back in the skies. Lida Rose.
Okay, hey, sister. I'm inviting your house to explain it to you every time you sweet, but always seem to meet people around. Mostly ladies.
Oh, yes, Mrs. Squire's in front of the ladies.
I'm glad. What money is going to be my time? What?
No, ma'am. Well, it's evidently not the convenient night. I'll see you at the sociable later.
Professor Hill, is it true that you... Well, you haven't heard it... Well, I'm trying to say so.
Yes?
Is it true that... Have you really developed the think system?
What? Oh, the think system! Yes, that's really very simple. As simple as listening. You only have to think if you have come out clearly here. Now, just try this yourself before you ask any questions.
I take your word.
Can we sit down?
Are all music teachers as dense as I am?
All music teachers?
Fancy, you make dozens. Is it all?
Well,
but they all put the strategy in his mind. Think system.
Some more, some less. One young lady actually thought of the same system before I got to her town. Showed me a few refinements.
I see.
But I said something wrong.
Professor, can I show you have many more important things to do than explain think system to me?
Can't think of why.
I must be very dull to me for men of course.
Now say, where'd you ever get an idea like that?
One hears rumors of traveling salesmen.
Now, Miss Marion, you must believe everything you hear. After all, what even hears rumors about my earrings?
I suppose you're referring to Uncle Maddie.
Uncle Maddie?
Mr. Madison, my father's best friend. No matter what they say, he left me in a sure job, so mother and Winthrop and I can have some security. Now surely you don't
of
believe.
Of course not. Why do you think people start those rumors?
Never mind this. Jealousy. Jealousy mostly, I guess.
Exactly. And jealousy is what mostly starts rumors about traveling salesmen. What have you heard?
Nothing about him personally, just generally.
What have you heard generally?
Well, of course it stands to reason that, well, disappointment and jealousy can lead to... Well, I mean, take your attention to possible men, teachers. Might easily be misinterpreted, mightn't they? I mean, not honestly, mightn't they?
Well, they have, sir.
And so you see, if a salesman were jealous, something like that, they could be downright lies, couldn't they?
Of course, sir.
So you see, you shouldn't believe everything you hear. I mean, if you just discuss things.
Miss Marion, I would be delighted to discuss anything in the world with you right now. Can we do it sitting down? I mean, you just sit. Your knees bend, you know.
You can sit over here on the floor.
You can also sit on the large hall log with the footbridge.
I've been thinking about you being the footbridge man in my life.
Just as tall.
I can't. I've got to dress for the social.
Then meet me there in 15 minutes.
I can't. Another time. Tomorrow, maybe.
My dear little librarian, I'll open up tomorrow so you'll find you collected nothing but a bunch of empty yesterdays. I don't know about you, but I'd like to make today with remembering.
So would I.
15 minutes.
15 minutes. Mama! What? I just told Professor Hill I'd make it to the footbridge in 15 minutes!
Glory be, and the saints be praised!
Well, the truth is almost longer.
Oh.
Halfway through, I almost
Jack, you broke balance, didn't I?
Right now, she saw a balance kick off of a cat book of a hurricane.
Listen, Buster Brown, I've gone through the ranks of this skirmish, and I'm not retiring without my commission.
Well, you can't get anywhere right after I'm a footbridge.
Place over a massive picnic park near the social makes this footbridge look like an old lady's home. Now, beat it, go get the ring. Never a piece of law in the music business. Now, where were we?
You were about to tell you, but I didn't know about you.
We don't have some of that now, do we?
No. Wherever for that matter, Harold. The librarian hasn't done much to apply green research lately. But she did a lot when you first came here.
Oh? About what?
About Professor Harold Hill, Garrett Conservatory, class lot 5. Harold, there wasn't any Garrett Conservatory in lot 5.
Why, there certainly was.
The tower was built to lot 6. I'll see you at the social later.
You knew all the time.
Since July 7th, 3 days after you came here. Since recently, again. Now I think it's going to fall my heart.
But if you knew, why didn't you? Why, you little.
No. Now go, please.
Professor,
forget your stubborn eye or chip on the shoulder arrogance long enough to remember River City before Harold Hill came. Do you remember? Well, do you? I should think you all would be grateful for him in his minutes.
You're wasting a great deal of time here. If there's a person here who does not think this man should be tarred and feathered, let him raise his hand. You, Larry, put your arm down.
Thank you, kids.